Hello everyone, my name is Deepak. I'm from Genesis Training. I'm here to explain you one other topic asked in SSC CGL exam. Now, what are the different topics asked in SSC CGL? We all know it is verbal, quant, logical reasoning and general awareness. Now, I'm here to explain you one other topic asked in SSC CGL, that is miscellaneous. Okay, we have combined two topics here, miscellaneous and find the missing number. Now, what happens in SSC CGL is they ask different, sure question, one guaranteed question in SSC CGL about miscellaneous and one sure question about find the missing number. Now, there are around 60 questions totally, which we will be discussing now. And all the 60 questions are taken from SSC CGL previous year question papers. Okay, so we have not created any question. These are asked in SSC CGL from the previous years. Clear? So let's understand what is SSC CGL. Let's understand what is miscellaneous. Okay, the topic name for today is miscellaneous. Okay, miscellaneous. Now, what is miscellaneous? Now, the questions will be something like this. Okay, imagine it's a properly drawn square. Not this one, I'll tell you totally once I finish it. Okay, imagine these are all squares. Okay, it is a properly 4 cross 4 square. Now, we need to find out total number of squares. How many squares are there here? That is the question asked. These are the kind of question asked in SSC CGL. So, let's count. This is, I'll use some other color now. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So, that means how many are 1 cross 1? There are totally 16. Right? 5, 6, 7, 8, 12, totally 16. Correct. Next, what about 2 cross 2? Now, what is 2 cross 2? 2 cross 2 is nothing but, I'll highlight you if you want. Now, 2 cross 2, 2 cross 2 will be these ones. These are 2 cross 2, correct? Okay, this is 2 cross 2. So, how many 2 cross 2 are there? It is not 1, 2, 3, 4. No, that is where we go wrong. It is, see, one was this part. That is 1. Second one is this part. Second and third box. Even this is 2 cross 2. Correct. So similarly, last one, that is here. Even this is 2 cross 2. Correct. So from that, we can say that how many were here? Totally 3. Correct. Totally there were 3. How many will be here? 3. And how many will be at the last 2? 3. Totally 2 cross 2 are 9. Okay, next, 3 cross 3. What are 3 cross 3? If I do it with the box, 3 cross 3 will be, I'll use some bigger square. So this will be 3 cross 3. Yes or no? It is getting confused. This part, the whole green pink part is 3 cross 3. So how many 3 cross 3 are there? One was that. One will be this. Correct. One will be this. Okay, the last one will be this. Correct. So how many are there in total? So 3 cross 3, there are totally 4. How many 4 cross 4? 1. Which is that one? The bigger one, outer one. That is 4 cross 4. Clear? So that is how they ask questions. So how many squares are there in total? 16 plus 9, 25 plus 4, 29 plus 1, 30. Now, you might think this is a little difficult to remember, right? So, what is the easy method to solve questions asked on find the number of squares? Okay, what is the easy method? easy method is 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, in this direction. Next, downwards, 1, 2, 3, and 4, okay. Only when n into n is given, that is here it is 4 cross 4, same matrix is given, not the different matrices, okay. How to do this? 1 square, okay, then plus 2 square, plus 3 square, plus 4 square, okay, simple as that. If n into n is 5 into 1, plus 5 square. So what is 1 square? 1, 2 square is 4, 3 square is 9, 4 square is 16, 5 totally 30, which is what we got in the previous question, okay. Now if the same question understood, 1 square, 2 square, 3 square, 4 square, that's your answer, simple. Now if the same question is asked something like this, the same question is asked with one more box, something like this, okay. There is one more box here, there is one more box here. Now we know without this boxes the answer is 30. Now with this boxes 1, 2, 3, 4 and the outer square 5 plus 5, so 1, 2, 3, 4 plus outer square plus 5, the answer is 40. Simple. Now you understood how to solve it. Yes. So these are the miscellaneous questions. Okay. So we'll solve questions from actual SSC CGL paper. Let's solve question number one. Question number one. How many triangles are there in the figure PQRS? Okay. So if you want, I'll redo the diagram. Okay. Something like this. The figure is something like this. So this is P, Q, R, and S. Right. Now, first step, we'll count the triangles which are clearly visible. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. These small triangles are clearly visible. So we need not worry about those too much. So 8 triangles we got to know, that we'll write it separately, okay. 8 we've written separately. Now next ones, which are the next ones? Now next ones will be the little bigger ones. Remove this, okay. How many triangles are there? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, so plus 4, okay. Next, sorry, just erased. We got plus 4, right? So these are the little bigger ones. So we'll draw the lines again. Next, still the bigger ones. Which are the bigger ones? Which are the bigger triangles? Remaining bigger triangles, we have PQR, triangle PQR. That is this big. If we want, I'll just share it with some other color. Okay, I'm talking about this one. Full year. This one, okay, getting it? This triangle. So if I remove this, this is the triangle I'm talking about. Clear? PQR. One more triangle will be PSR, right? So what are the next triangles remaining? This side done, this side done. Now towards the upper sides, that is, if you remove these, you got two more triangles, correct? Which are those? P S Q and Q S R. So totally how many? Plus 4 again. So 8 plus 4 plus 4. The answer is how many triangles? 16 triangles. 16 triangles. Correct. So that is option A. 16 triangles. Clear? Yes. We'll go for next one. Yes, we'll go for next one. Let's solve question number 2. Question number 2 says, how many squares are there in the figure ABCD? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So we already solved this question actually, correct? How do you solve this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, sorry, 2, 3, and 4. So 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus 4 square. How much is that? It is 30. And I told you the shortcut methods to solve this. The answer is 30. Simple one, very, very simple one. Which is answer 30? Option D. So mark option D and go for next one. When I explained you the concept, I told you this only, right? So very simple one, 30. So mark it and go for next one. Question number three is find the number of rectangles. Find the number of rectangles. How many rectangles are there? Okay. So how many rectangles are there? Let's find out. So first of all, we can easily see some of the rectangles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, and one more thing. Squares are special form of rectangles. Okay, so squares are special form of rectangles. So even squares are included. So since we got 8 there, that I'll write it as separately here, 8. Okay, even this part is considered as special form of rectangle. This is the pink one which I'm drawing. So how many are there? 1, you have 2, you have 3, and you have 4 totally. So those are the 4 special form of rectangles. Those are squares. So plus 4. Okay, now what are the remaining ones? I'll draw the diagram here again. One way of solving this is writing everywhere all the variables y, a, b, c, d, e, f, g, h, I, j, k, l. We'll have m, n, o, p, q. Writing everything everywhere, that is one way of doing it. So let's count the rectangles now. Okay, so we already have 8 plus 4. Remaining ones. Now, you can go with this method, that is writing all the variables or simply using these shaded ones. Okay. Now, this is one rectangle. The shaded part is one rectangle. If you take in your written term, it is ACPK. One rectangle, yes, no? A, C, P, K is one rectangle. Similarly, so that is one. I'll add one. Even this full till here is a rectangle. Correct? So this is one. This one also. 1, so 2 done, correct, 2 done, we'll count in our head. Next will be this one, 3, this will be 4, right? So plus 4 we need to do. Plus 4. Okay, now what else is remaining? There are still remaining ones. Upper side we did, lower side, that is this portion. This is 1, correct. Then this is 1, two done, right. Is there anything left out? I don't think anything we have left out. We have done with everything. So add plus 2. What's the total? 8 plus 4. That is 12, 13 plus 7. 8 plus 4, 12, 13. 13 plus 4, 17 plus 2, 19. Okay. So did we leave any squares? Let's check once. We have taken this, we have taken this, taken this. Okay, bigger one you have not considered, so plus 1. The outer side one, right? The outer side one is also a rectangle, correct? So is there anything else left out? Okay, so we got 20, that is here, 8 plus 4 plus 1 plus 4 plus 1 makes it 18 19 20, but 20 option is not there, so that means we have left out something. Okay, so let's see what is that something. Okay, what is that something? I did not fill the figure completely. Okay, correct? No, so what is that something? That is this part, BDQF, so that is plus 1. So total is 21. Total is 21, right? Yes, mark the option and go for next one. Option C, 21. For question number 4 says how many rectangles? Okay, how many rectangles? So first we'll count the rectangles which are easy. So first is the bigger one, so that is 1. Then we have 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so plus 4, right? So simple basic ones we calculated. Next, using the highlighter, I'll explain you now. So which are the remaining ones? This is 1, correct? So I'll write 1. Next, we have this whole part, 2, correct? Then we have this whole part, that is 3. So we need to add plus 3. Okay, if you're getting confused, I'll do one thing. I'll do the diagram again here. Use the same black color. Okay. Same diagram, right? So first what we did, we calculated everything. 1 is the bigger square, 1 plus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, correct? Plus 5. Now what we are doing? Remaining ones. So this one, the shaded one, is 1, correct? Similarly, so from there we got plus 1, right? Similarly, the whole part, this completely, from here to here. So this is a rectangle, correct? So that is how much? Plus 1 again. Plus 1, right? Next, what is left out? This whole part. I'll use the highlighter, this whole part, correct, this one, that is 1, so plus 1, okay, then what is left out? What is left out is this part. This is also a rectangle, correct? Also a rectangle. So that is 1 plus 1. How many done? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 plus 5, 10. Okay. So is there anything left out? Yes. What we did previously, this is previously done. We considered this from here to here, one triangle. From here to here, we consider one more triangle. From here to here, we considered three triangles, right? But we missed out the reverse part, from here to here. Even this is a rectangle. Yes or no? Yes. Okay. So that is plus 1 again. So total it is 11. Okay. If you are not getting these kind of solution, you can simply go for this one. Take this as A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K. Okay, first triangle will be ABIJ, next triangle will be ACKJ, KI, so next will be AD, EI. So on, you need to write everything. So instead of wasting so much of time, so I did this method. Okay, we got 11 triangles totally. Sorry, 11 rectangles in a total. Okay, so mark it and go for next one. Next one, question number 5. What is question number 5 saying? How many rectangles? Okay, so first let's count the simple ones. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, 6 is there. So that is done. Next, we'll calculate the next ones. We'll count together. Okay. So, this is the one. Both together. 1. This is 2. Correct. This is 3. Right. So, how many done? 3 done. Okay. Next. This is 4. This is 5. Okay. Then 5 done, so we'll add 5 plus 5 first, so plus 5 is done. Okay, next remaining ones, so we did these two, even these two are triangles, 1, 2, correct, 2 done. Next, fully from here to here, 3, and from here to here, 4, correct, 4 done. Last one will be the whole triangle, 5, correct, so 5 done. We'll add that 5, no confusion. Next, what is remaining? 2 cross 2, which is that 2 cross 2? These ones, okay. These ones which start from here to here. This is 1, correct, and one more is this 2. Okay, so these are all the triangles in this given question. So total is 6 plus 5, 11, 11 plus 7 is 18. Is that option there? Yes, it is there. Option D, 18. Simple one. Okay, so save it and go for next one. Question number 6. What is question number 6 saying? How many triangles? Okay, so let's try drawing. I'll try drawing it in a bigger fashion. Okay, I'll somehow manage to draw it. Yes, you got it. First, let's count the simple one. One is a bigger triangle, outside triangle, outer triangle. that is 1. Then we have 1, 2, 3, 4 plus 4, right? Then what else? For this, if you want, I will give you this example: A, B, C, D, E, F. What is this 1? A, F, E, that is 1. What is this 4? A, F, B, B, F, C, C, F, D, and D, F, E. Okay, next one. Next remaining are A, C, F, that is these two together. Next one, A, D, F, the next three together. Okay, next one. So this A is done. Next B, B, C, F is done. So B, D, F, so B, D, F. Next is B, B, D, F is done. B, E, F. Correct. Next, so B is done. Next, C. C, D, F is done. So, E, C, E, F. So, C, E, F. Okay. Any other triangles remaining? Everything is done. So, 5 plus 5. So, total it is 10. Check whether option 10 is there. It is there. It is option D. Clear? So, both the methods are easy. This was a very simple one. Correct. So, mark your answer and go for next one. Next one, question number 7. How many rectangles are there in the given picture? Okay. So, first rectangle, we'll take the bigger ones. That is, in the picture, there are two bigger triangles. One is like this. One more is like this. Correct. Two. Those are two rectangles. Then, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, those are 5 rectangles. Now, remaining ones. Okay. So, remaining ones, how are they? They are little hidden. So how are they written? I'll help it with the highlighter. So one thing which is hidden is from here to here. This is one. Correct. Okay. Second one is from here to here. This is one more. Two. Yes. Next one is this one. Three. Correct. Next one is from here to here, 4, right, 4. So, is there anything else? Sorry. So, you got plus 4, what's the total? 5 plus 4 plus 2, 11. Is there anything other triangle? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, so 8. 9, 10, and 11. Yes, it is 11. All the triangles are covered. Answer is 11. That is option. Is there option B? 11. Option B. Simple one. Simple question. Yeah. So save it and go for next one. Question number 8. What is question number 8 saying? How many triangles? So let's first find out all the triangles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That 8 we got. Next, which are the next ones? So 8 we got, right? 8. Next ones are these ones. Okay, I'll just shade it for you. This one, correct? So 1, this will be 2. Okay, similarly this side it will be 3. And this side it will be 4. So 8 plus 4. How much is that? 12. There are 12 triangles in the given picture. Yes. Yes, it is. Okay. So mark it. That is option C. 12 and go for next one. Simple one. These are simple ones. Next one. Question number 9. So question number 9, I'll try to draw in a bigger pattern. I'll draw with red only, black only. Okay. Sorry. So there's a line like this. Line like this. Somewhere like this, correct. So question is, what's the question? What's the question? Question is obviously triangle. Okay, let's count the triangles. So first, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six triangles. So six we already have. Then remaining plus. So this will remove. So 6 is done. Next one will be, if I take this as A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, and this as O. Okay. Next one will be triangle AOC. Okay, this part. AOC. Similarly, you will have COE. Correct. Similarly, you have COE is done. This side nothing is possible. Two done. Next, bigger triangle, that is ACE and AGE. So this full from here to here, and this full from here to here. So totally 4. Okay, answer is 10. I'm stopping right here because there's only one option, which is 10 rest all are less than 10. Clear? So 10 should be my answer. 10 is the answer. Okay, so mark it and go for next one. Question number 10. Find the number of squares. Okay, let's count. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This will be 9th one, the small square. 9, and this will, outer one will be 10. That's it, I guess. 10. Simple one. I think 10 should be the answer. Yes, 10. Why I'm telling it should be the 10? Because there is no other square. Because they have a square, not a rectangle, it's square. So 10, 10 squares. 10 squares are there, simple. Okay, 10 squares are there, right? Yes, I think this can be followed with the previous method. 1 square plus 2 square is 5. For smaller 1, square plus 2 square, 5 plus 5, 10. Clear? Answer is 10. Clear? Mark it and go for next one. Question number 11. These are the questions which are of type 2 in miscellaneous. That is, they will give you matrix. There will be a matrix here. Now, the word is calm. C-A-L-M, calm. Okay. So, where is that word calm? Which number represents calm? Now, it is easy to go with options. Now, first option says 53. So, check whether 53 has C, letter C. 53 is for C. Okay. So, 5 is here, 3 is here. So, 53 is C. So, that is correct. Next. For A, what they have said? 42. I'm going with the options. 42. Check 42. So 4 is here, 2 is here. So in this area, there should be A. Yes, it is. So 42 is correct. L, 65 they are given. Let's check whether it is 65. So 6 is here. So 5 is here. L is here. 65. That is also correct. Next, for M, what they have given? 36. Okay, 36. So 3 is here. 6 is here. Is it M? No. So option A is not possible. Okay, we go for option B. 53, we already checked, it is correct. For A, this time they have given 54. There can be multiple answers. Okay, multiple answers in the sense not from options, from the given figure. Okay, for A, it can have, like here 54 they have given 5. So 4 is O. So option 2 is also not possible. Option 3, what is option 3? So option 3 is 44, 54. We already got to know that 54 cannot be the answer. Even here, it cannot be the answer. So obviously, it is option 4, the right answer. So let's check. Okay. So what I'll do is, I'll check only option 4. What does option 4 say? Yes. Option 4 says 44, 62, 65, and 51. Now, we'll check with the given options for calm. So C, A, L, and M. C, 44. Is it 44? 4 and 4. Yes, it is C. So C is possible. For A, we have said 62. So 6 is here, 2 is here, A is here. So 62, that is also correct. Next, 65. 6 is here. So 5 is here. It should be L. It is L. Okay. Yeah, next m, it should be 51. 5 is here, 1 is here, m is here. So this is how you solve matrix question other than miscellaneous. So option 4 is the answer. 44, 62, 65 and 51. Okay, so once you practice this, you will be very faster. Here the answer is option D. Yes, yes, we'll go for next one. Question number 12. Again, these kind of questions are definitely asked in the paper, that is in SSC CGL. Okay, now I'll just write down the options first, so it will be easy for us. Option A says 32, 00, 56 and 10. So let's check with option A whether this is working. The word is card, C-A-R-D, card. Okay, so word is card, C-A-R-D. First check C, whether C is 32. So 3 is here, 2 is here, C is here. So that is correct. 00, zero, it is A. That's also correct. R, it is not here, it will be here. R is 56. So 5 is here, 6 is Q. So option A is wrong. Okay, option A is wrong. Now let's check with option B. What's option B saying? 40, 21, 68, 44. What was it? 40, 21, 68 and 44, option B. Okay, since it is a small screen, I'm not getting to accommodate a whole thing. If I do it, it will be, the text will be very small. So when you are writing in an examination, they'll give a bigger screen. It will not, this problem will not have where you're going up and down. Okay, so let's check with this one. First, like whether the options are correct. 40, 21, 68, 44. Yes. Okay. Now, card. This time it is card. C, A, R, D. Correct. So 40. 4, 0 is C. Correct. Now, for A, it should be 21. 2 and 1 is A. Correct. R, it is 68. So 6, it is R. Yes. For D, it is 44 given, 4, 4 is B, so not possible. So option B is also wrong. Getting it, how to solve this now? You might think, why should I go with every time options? This is, saves a little more time, okay? Or else you would write all the values. Option C is 11, 33, 57 and 22. Okay, let's check again. So C, A, R and D. 11, whether it is C? Yes. For A, is it 33? 3 and 3. Yes. R, is it 57? 5 and 7. R, yes. 22, is it D? 2 and 2. It is D. So the right answer is option C. That's it. Okay. That's how you solve miscellaneous questions. These kind of miscellaneous questions. Option C is the right answer. Yes. Yes, mark it and go for next one. Next one, question number 13. What is question number 13 saying? We have to find out for play. Okay, so P, L, A and Y. What is option A saying? 43, 36, 42 and 23. Let's check. 43, whether it is P. So 4 and 3, 43. Is it P? Yes, it is. Next, 36. So 3 is here, 6 is here. Is it L? Yes, it is. Okay. Next, A. They have said 42. Let's check. So 4 is here, 2 is here. Is it A? Yes, it is A. Let's check for Y. They have said 23, 2 and 3 is not Y. Okay. It's not Y. So now, if you watch it carefully, where is Y? Y is 1 is here. Is there any Y other than that? What is that number? 4 and 5. So the right option should be ending with 45. Yes or no? That's how you become smart. That's how you use your brain or kidney, whatever. Y is only in one place. So which option is having 45 at the end? There are two options which are having 45 at the end. Correct. That is option C and option D. Now let's cross verify. So option A and option B, we need not do it. Okay. Now let's check option C. Okay. Let's check option C. What is option C? 15, 12, 42, 45. If this is correct, we got your answer. If this is wrong, we got the answer. Okay. So we need not do it for all the options here. So let's check whether this works. This should be P, L, A, Y. This anyways, we know it is correct. Let's check for P. P. 15. Yes. L is 12. They have said no. So option C is wrong. We now got to know A, option B, option C are wrong. So obviously option D should be correct. That's how you save time. Correct. So that is option D here. Option D is correct. Okay. Yes. We'll go for next one. Yes, we'll go for next one. Next one, question number 14. The word is best. B-E-S-T. So B-E-S and T. Okay. So what are the options? First options are 24, 22. Okay. Okay. See, all the first one are 24. So we need not check for B only. We know B is 24. E, they have said 22, 22, 21 and 22. We'll check for 22. If 22 is wrong, we obviously know it is C. If 22 is correct, we got to know that C cannot be the answer. Getting it? Okay. So let's check B now first. Whether E is 22 or not. 22 is E. That means what? Option 3 is wrong. Option 3 is wrong. 22 is correct. Next, similarly, check for yes. Yes has 77, 76, 77, 77. If 77 is correct, what does that mean? If 77 is correct, it can be either A or B. Correct. Why A or B? A, B or D. Sorry, A, B or D. If it is not 77, we got our answer. Yes. So 77 is yes. 77 is yes. So which are the options which can be correct now? So 24, 22, 77, yes, it is there. 24, 22, 76, no. 24, 21, no. So either the answer should be 96 or 97. So let's check for 96. A or D. Okay. A or D. So let's check for 96. So 96. It should be T. 9 and 6 is not T. It is yes. So the answer should be here 97. That is 97 is T. Got it now? So 24, the answer is 24, 22, 77 and 97, that is option D. Clear? That's option D. 24, 22, 77 and 97. Clear? So that's how, if you practice this method, this becomes very, very easy for you to solve. Getting my point? Yes. So save your answer and go for next one. Next one, question number 15. Question number 15 says, find the number of triangles. Okay, let's count. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 we already got, right? Now remaining ones. So this part is a triangle. That is, this part is a triangle. So 1, even this part is a triangle. So 2, correct. So plus 2, right? Plus 2. Done. Next, what else is remaining? This whole thing is a triangle. Correct. That is 1. This side it is. One more. 2. Correct. So plus 2. Okay. Even this side, the other side. 1. And this side, one more. So plus 2. What's the total? 6 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 is how much? What's the answer? It is 12. It is 12. Clear? Yes. So answer is 12. Option D. Yes. Yes. market and go for next one. Question number 16, okay, I'll draw it again for our understanding. It will be the one. Okay. Okay. Now, let's number this. So this is A, B, C, this will be D, E, and F. Okay, so we'll collect all the triangles now. First with the bigger one, A, B, C. Next, A, F, C. A, E, C. Okay, next we all finish with A. A, D, E. This triangle, A, D, E. Next, A, D, F. And similarly, A, B, F. A, B, D. A, B, D. Okay. So, A is done. Now, from the other side. Okay. We start with C. C, D, E. Okay. C, D, F. And C, D, D. Clear? Next. What else we have? So, how many done? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 done. Okay, we are done with 9. Done. Next, I'll just erase this. If you want to write it somewhere else, so I need some space to calculate other triangles. Okay. Now. So we took ADE, ADF, even AEF is a triangle, correct? AEF is a triangle. AEB is a triangle. Similarly, AFB is a triangle. Here, on the other side, CEF is a triangle. Then we have CEB as a triangle. Then we have CFB as a triangle. So, plus 6. How much is the total? 15 triangles. 15 triangles are there. That's option B. 15 triangles. Anything else left out? I don't think so. No, there's no triangles left out. Clear? So mark it and go for next one. Let's solve question number 17. Question number 17 says complete the series of figures by selecting correct answers from the given responses. Okay, this come under pattern series. Okay, now what is pattern series? First, let's check out the box. Okay, what box? I'm talking about this box. Okay, the small box we have, right? Which is the box I'm talking about? I'm talking about this small box here. Okay, this is this box. Now, what has happened is, initially, first diagram, I'll write the numbering for you. This first diagram, second diagram, third diagram, fourth diagram. Where is that box in the first diagram? In this direction. Okay. If I take this as center, it is in that direction. Next, first diagram, it is here. Second diagram, where did that box go? It came here. Right? See, it came here. Second diagram. Third diagram, what happened to that? Third diagram, where did the box go? It went downstairs. Right? See, third diagram, it came here. 45 degrees. Next, at last, it has come down. Fourth. Okay. So, if this is a movement, this is what movement? Clockwise movement. Correct. Clockwise movement. So, next will be what movement? I'll use a different color. So, next will be, the box should be somewhere here. Or in your direction sense terms, it should be in the south west direction. Okay, so which is that option? Option 1 or option 3. Correct? See here, southwest direction. One thing we got, option 2 and option 4 are wrong. Now, let's see which one is correct out of 1 and 3. Okay, let's see the black dot. So, black dot was here, then came here, next on the center, then it went here. Okay, I'll use the same color if you want. I'm talking about black dot. Initially, it was here, correct? Then it came downwards, then on the below, then it came here. So, at last, it should be here, the bigger one, which are bigger one I'm doing. So, black dot should be on the right side for us. So, right side for us is option 3 here, correct? So, this is not
possible. That is wrong, right? So black and white also moment we have to check. So we check two moments. One is the box, black box, and black dot. So black dot is moving in which direction? Anti-clockwise direction. Okay, anti-clockwise direction. So which is the right answer? Right answer is figure 3 will be the next option. Figure 3 will be the next option, right? Yes, let's move on to next one. Next one, question number 18. Question number 18 says, okay, so they've drawn a diagram. So I'll try drawing the diagram here, okay, so that it becomes simpler. Why I'm doing this is it will be easy to explain, okay? So I'll try to draw hexagon. Okay, so I'll write the numbering. I'll tell you why I'm writing numbering. This is first one, second, third, fourth, fifth, and sixth triangle. Imagine, okay? So after six, again it will come here. So 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Next circle. Okay. Why I'm doing that is there's a reason for that. Okay. The reason is initially where's the dot? It is here. Initially. Okay. So initially it is in 1. Next, where did it go? It went to 3. Next, it went to 3. Correct. Next, where did it go in the third figure? It went to 6. It went to 6. Correct. Next, where did it go? It went to 4. Not 4. One more cycle. It came here. Okay. So from 1 to 3, 3 to 6. Again, one more round. That is 10 now. Correct. It went to 10. Where will be the next moment? See. What is the difference here? The difference here is 2. The difference here is 3. The difference here is 4. The next difference should be 5. What is difference 5? It should be 15. Correct. So we have 12. Next will be 13. Here this will be 14. This will be 15. So it should come to this place where I put pink mark. Okay. The next dot should come here. Correct. Which is that? Option 4. Figure number 4. Correct. Figure number 4. Understood? That's why I used all these numberings. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Again one more cycle. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Again one more cycle. 15th one. Okay. So these are pattern series questions. So answer is figure number 4 and option 4. Clear? Option 4. We'll move on to next one. Question number 19. Question number 19 is actually very simple. Why I'm telling it is simple is first it was horizontal vertical line, then horizontal line, then vertical line, then it became, then it should be horizontal line. Correct? First vertical, horizontal, vertical, next should be horizontal. So option 1 and option 3 are wrong. We clearly understood. Okay, it should be either 2 or it should be 4. Correct. Now first, how many arrow marks are there in this figure? How many arrow marks are there? 1. In next figure, how many arrow marks are there? 3. Next figure, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Correct. In the next 1, 3, 5, next should be 7 arrow marks. Yes or no? Which option has 7 arrow mark out of 2 and 4? Option 4 has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this cannot be the answer. See here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So answer is option figure number 2. Clear? Figure number 2. So mark your answer option B. Clear? First lines, then the number of arrow marks. Simple. Very simple. Next one. We'll move on to next one. Question number 20. Question number 20. First, again, same like previous one. First, the diagram was like this. Okay, I'll use the arrow mark. First, it was like this. First diagram. Second, it is like this. Straight. Third, it is like this. The question mark is should be like this. Correct, no? I'll write the numbering. First figure was downwards. Second figure was towards the west side. Third, towards northwest. And fourth should be here. Fourth should be here. So, this is the question mark one. So everything is like that. So let's count the number of petals now. How many are there here? 2 petals. Here 3. Here 4. Next should be 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this can be the answer. This 1, 2, 3, 4 cannot be the answer. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this can be the answer. Option 4 cannot be the answer. So right options are 1 or 3. Okay. Now see, initially first stage, I'll use the color here. First stage, it had two petals like this. Correct? Two petals like this. Then it had two. Where did that third one join? Towards the right side. Correct? Towards the right side, the third one joined. Okay. Fourth one joined to the left side now. So fifth one should have 1, 2, 3, 4. First, towards the right side, one petal should join. Getting it? First, it had like this in the first figure. In the second figure, we had like this and this here. Okay. That is to our right side, one petal got added. In the third figure, what happened? You had a line like this. You completed it. And the fourth figure, again, it should be like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, which is already there. And we should fix it to the right side. Now, which is that? That is option 3. So, option 1 is wrong. Option 3 is correct. Understood, no? First, the lines, then the number of petals, then which side the petal is added. So, in this case, which side the petal is added? It is added to option 3. Figure number 3. Clear? Yes. Mark that option and go for next one. Number 21. Question number 21 says, again, find the missing figure in the series from the given other from the other figures. Okay. So first thing to understand. First, X mark cross X mark cross. Next should be X mark. We understood that it will be X mark. Okay. So from that we can easily say option 3 is wrong. Because that is cross mark. Plus mark. We need to get cross mark. Second thing to understand is, see, this circle, that is the bigger circle, is rotating and the smaller circle is rotating. Both bigger circle and the smaller circle, the double one, both are rotating 45 degrees clockwise. Yes or no? Both are rotating 45 degrees clockwise. Yes? So, what will be 45 degree rotation of this one? So, it will be bigger one here. That is a double double. And smaller one will be here. Correct. Because from here, 45 degree is like this from the fourth figure. And even this is downwards. Right. So, which is that option? That is option 1. Correct. That's option 1. Option 2 cannot be possible. Option 3 is anyways wrong. Option 4 is anyways wrong because the bigger one is opposite to bigger ones, not the smaller ones. Okay. So it is option 1, figure number 1. Clear? That is figure number 1. Yes. So mark your answer and go for next question. Next one. Question number 22. Question number 22. Very, very, very simple question. Why very simple? First, the arrow mark is like this. Then it became like this in the second figure, in the third figure, this one, and the answer figure, I will do it in a different one, this one, obviously this one. Why? Because the rotation is something like this. So first, from here to here, this is the first figure, this is second figure, third. So from here to here it came, and it should be here to here, and it should be a square. Okay, so the answer should be something like this. Okay, a box and arrow mark facing this side. Which is that option? That is option 2. Very simple question, very direct question. So mark your option, that is option 2, and go for next one. Second figure. See, second option 3 and 4 are not at all possible because those are not squares. Option 1 is in reverse case. So option 2. Yeah, simple one, very simple one. Yes. Let's move on to next one. Next one. First, let's see the dot. So, first figure, dot is here in one of the corners. Second figure, it went here. Third figure, it will be here. And the fourth figure, I'll write it in some other color, it should be here. Correct? It should be here, right? Because it went from here to here initially, then it went from here to here. I'll use the same color. Answer option, I'll use pink. First, it went from here to here. Next, it was here to here. and third, it came from this point to this point, right? So that one is done. Second thing, there is circle. How many circles are there? Three circles are there. So one, so this is second figure, third figure, and this will be the answer option, fourth figure. Okay, initially where is the arrow mark? It is here, correct? It is here. Next, it went like this. So what is the movement? It is clockwise. It is clockwise movement. So next is here. So what will be the answer one? It should be here, correct? So if you join both the answer should be a box here. There should be a box and the dot should be here, correct? The dot should be here. Which is that option? That is option 4. That's option 4. Yes. Again, a simple one, not very difficult, simple one. Option 4 it is. Clear? Yes. The dot is moving anti-clockwise and the line is moving clockwise. That's it. Okay. Mark the option and go for next one. Move on to question number 24. I think question number 24 should be very, very easy. Why very, very easy? In the first figure, the cross mark is here, the circle is here. In the second figure, the cross mark is here and the circle is here. In the third figure, so from here it moved till here, then from here it moved till here, so it became cross mark and circle. At last it will move here, so answer will be first cross mark will come, then circle will come. Okay, this is the answer option. This should be the answer option, which is that is option A. Simple. Everything is moving clockwise. Everything is moving clockwise. Okay. So answer is one. Figure number one. Simple, no? Yes. Let's move on to next one. Next one, question number 25. Question number 25. Okay. How many circles are there? First diagram, one. First diagram, one. Second diagram, there are two. Third diagram, there are three. And fourth diagram, it should be one, two, three, and four. Okay. Next, lines. Check the lines. First, there are one, two, three, four. One, two, three in the second one. One, two in the third one. Next one should be only one. Which is that option? Option one. Simple. Option one. Correct. The circles are increasing. The curvy lines are decreasing. Simple. First one is the answer. Right. Yes, we'll move on to next one. Yes, we move on. Question number 26. Okay. In the first figure, we have arrow mark. Second figure, we have two arrow marks. Third figure, we have three arrow marks. So fourth one, the answer option should have 1, 2, 3, and 4. Correct. So this is from first figure, second figure, third, and fourth. Next thing, what has happened there is, in the first figure they had a line here, from the cross mark they had a line here. Next figure, from the cross mark they have added one more line. In the third figure they have added three more lines. So answer option will be straight lines, two. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, which is that option? Option 1. Some people get confused here with option 4. Option 4 is cross mark, but option 1 is plus mark. It should be plus mark. See all the diagrams, it is plus, 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 and plus. So answer is option 1, figure number 1, which is in box. Okay, so answer is 1, figure 1. Clear? Yes. Next, question number 27. So it looks like a butterfly. Okay, so we all know the answer is horizontal, right? See, all the options are horizontal. We need to only calculate the lines. First, start with the line. So first figure, how many lines are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. Second figure, only 3. Third figure, only 2. So last figure, it should have only one line. Okay. So one line. Now, which is that one line? See, from here it rotated 90 degrees and one line went. Okay, that was this line went off. So this line went off. When that line goes, you get this. Next, what happened? This line went off. You got this. So if you go with same, though it is going in anti-clockwise direction, if you go with same direction, it will go, this one will go. Okay. When this goes, after this becomes rotation, it becomes something like this. Okay. Sorry. Okay. So now the figure is like this. Okay. The line is like this. When it rotates, the line becomes like this. Correct, no? Because we removed this part and we rotated it. So the answer is fourth one, not the first one. People go wrong here. It's not the first one. We clock anti-clockwisely, we are removing the line, and after rotation, it becomes option four. Clear? Option four is the answer. That is figure number four. Yeah? Mark that answer and go for next question. Right? Question number 28 says, okay. Question number 28. See it very carefully. And the, okay. First, the tick mark was here. I'm comparing first one and second one. Okay. Watch very carefully. First, the tick mark was here. Okay. I'll draw the position of, okay, I'll make it very simple for you. I'll draw boxes. Okay. One box, two, three, four and five. These are the five places in the given question. Even here, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay. Now, first the tick mark was here. The tick mark was here. Yes. Next, what happened in the second figure? It is here. Yes. The top, the triangle was here. The triangle went down. The cross mark was here. In the second pair, it has interchanged. The circle has remained in the same place, and the box, the small box, has interchanged its position. So now you understood what should be done. So third figure is cross mark here, triangle here, box here, circle and tick mark. So first let's interchange this. So if you interchange this, so the triangle will come here, the cross mark will come here. The circle remains same. The triangle went up, the cross mark came down. The tick mark was in the right side, now it should come to the left side, and box should come to the right side. Which is that option? Tick mark cross, option A. Option A, right? Option A or first option. First figure, right? Understood? They have just interchanged their positions. Yeah. So mark that option and go for next question. Question number 29. What is question number 29 saying? Okay. Okay. Question number 29. See, the triangle, first place, the triangle was here. Correct. Second figure. Next figure, it came down. Okay. Third figure, it went here. Fourth figure, it should come here. Okay. From here to here, and here to here. 1, 1, 1 movement. For example, how do they move is, if you take a box, okay, these are like six positions, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Initially, triangle was here, it came here, it came here, it should come here, okay. Next thing, after triangle, what is following triangle? So in this box, I'm writing in green now. In this box, equal to was here. First, it came to this place, then it came to this place, it should come to this place. Okay. I will write the answer option in this color only, pink color. Okay. Where do you have triangle on the corner? That is right hand corner, option 1 and option 3. Where do you have this in the bottom, that is equal to in the bottom? Only in option 3. So option 1 is wrong, option 2 is wrong, option 3 is wrong. Clear? Very simple one. They are just rotating anti-clockwise. Every diagram is rotating anti-clockwise. So answer here is figure 3, answer number 3. So mark that option and go for next question. Clear? Question number 30. Question number 30. Okay, we'll do the circle. Okay, now we'll just concentrate on the black dot. Okay, how many are there? 1, 2. Okay, I'll just use the black color only. 1, 2, 1 in the first step. In the second step, where are they? If I take only cross mark, they are 1, 2, and 1. They have rotated clockwise. One step. In the this is the first figure. This is the second figure. Third figure now. This will be the fourth figure. Answer figure. Okay. So fourth figure, if you take the cross mark, two dots are here, small dot is here. So answer option should be the cross mark, two dots should be here, and small dot should be here. Okay. Which option is having that? Only option. Simple anti-clockwise rotation. That's it. That's it. Okay. So answer is figure number 1. Getting it? Yes. Simple ones, no? Not very difficult to understand. By seeing it, you should solve within seconds. So these are the questions. That's why SSCGL has 100 questions and 60 minutes only. So these are the questions. If there are 5 questions like this, you should solve these 5 questions in around 30 seconds. Or within 1 minute, 5 questions should be solved. Okay. So practice. So these are not very tough to solve. So don't make mistakes here. You have negative markings, right? We'll move on to next one. Question number 31. Simple one. We have all done this when we were kids, right? So we put box. So I'll just help it here. I'll just zoom if you want. Because zoom is not working. Yeah, zoom isn't working. So what happens is, first nothing was there. So first thing came here. Next thing came here. And last would be here only, clockwise. See, first here, second here, and third should be here, clockwise. And it should be have a box. Which one? It should have a three circle. It should have three circle. So option 2 or option 3 is correct. These two are wrong. So, but we know the curve should be clockwise, which is not there in third one. So what's the right answer? The right answer is figure number 2. Correct? No, figure number 2. Yes. First, second, and third, clockwise. Simple, very, very simple. Yes. Let's move on to next one. Let's solve question number 32. Now, question number 32. I'll do it like how I did in the one of the previous questions. Okay. Yes, 8 parts. Right. So, first, where was the, if I mark, I'll mark the portions. If this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So if you take these things, the dotted things, okay, it was in 1 initially, okay? It was in 1 initially. Then where did it go? It went to 6. It went to 6. Next, where did it go? So if I'm doing one more circle, after 8 it will be 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, right? So it went to 3, that is 11. That is 11. So what's the difference here? 5. What's the difference here? 5. Next difference should be 5. So it should be 16th one. Yes. So that should be here. That is, I'll do it in pink color. So it should come that whatever it is written, k or x or whatever, it should come to this small arc, okay, this small portion, it should be there. So that is possible in option 1 and option 2. That one we got. Next one, let's check the shaded part. Okay, let's check the shaded ones. Now we understood the dotted ones. I'll remove this. I'll remove this completely. Okay. We know that answer is either 1 or 2. Now shaded part. Okay. Where was shaded part initially? It was here. Yes, it was there. Okay. If I take this as number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Okay. Like the previous one. So first it was there. Next, where did it go? From here, it went to this place, right? Sorry, it was not here. Initially, where was it? I saw this diagram, sorry. Initially, it was in 3, right? Initially, it was in 3. Next, where did it go? It went to 5. Next, where did it go? It went to 7. Now, I think you should have got the answer. It should be in 9th one. Okay, or else I'll change the color. It should be here. Okay, that is 9th one. It looks like a fan. So that is option. Which option? Okay, that is option this 2. Sorry, 1. Sorry, 1. Okay, 1. Figure 1. Correct, no? See, figure 2 is in 8, which should be in 9. Okay, figure 1. See, I got confused. Sorry. See, figure 1 is the answer. Figure 1 is the answer. Okay, clear? Yes. Yes, let's go on to next one. Next one. Okay. So, it was like this, incomplete figure. It became complete figure. Okay. First, it was like this. Then it became like this. It is like this now. The answer option should be like this. So, it is clear that option 3 is wrong, option 4 is wrong. Directly, elimination. Okay. Now, how many lines are there? One line is there. Nothing was added here. 0, 0, 1, and one line should be added. So, now, this has, if I take this line, okay, I'll try to draw that. The figure is something like this. Yes. So, there was one line initially. One line was there already. We have to just add one more line. That's it. Which is that? That is option 1. This has 3 lines, not required, because 0, 0, 1, 1, then 2, 2. Okay. So, 3 lines are not required. So, 0 it was initially. This was incomplete figure. First one was incomplete. Second one, it became complete. They added one line. Then it will become 2 line, 3 line. So, here, how many lines are there here? 0. How many lines are there here? 1. How many lines it will be there? It should be 2. So, that is which one? First figure. So, answer is first one. Yes. Mark it and go for next one. Question number 34. Very, very simple again. Why I'm telling very, very simple is, initially it was like this. Okay. Then it became like this. Now, what does that mean? It is rotating by 45 degrees, and in which direction? Anti-clockwise direction. Ulta, reverse, like this. So, next figure is like this, 45 degree movement. And the answer figure should be in, I am doing it in pink color, it should be like this. 45 degree again, clockwise. Which is that only option? That is option 1. Only option is option A1. Figure number 1. Simple? Yes. Let's move on to next one. Okay, question number 35. Okay, so we have 1, 9, 25. Then we have 4, 16, 36. So next is 9, 25, and question mark. What are these? 1 square, 3 square, 5 square. Next one, 2 square, 4 square, 6 square. Next one, 3 square, 5 square. What is question mark? 1, 3, 5. What is the equal distance? Difference, 2 difference, 2 difference. Again, 2 difference, 2 difference, right? Here difference is 2. Next difference should be 7. So, 2, again, that means 7 square. 7 square is what? 49. Okay. These come under a topic called as find the missing number in SSE CGL. So, find the missing number. The missing number is 49, which is option B. Yeah, mark it and go for next. Quickly go for next one. Question number 36. What is question number 36 saying? 15, 12, 3, 44, 28, 8, 64, 53, and question mark. Okay.
So 15, 12, we got 3, correct? So 15 minus 12 is 3, possible. 44, 28, we have 48, 8 here. So 44 minus 28 is not 8, so not possible, okay? So they are doing something else. So let's add them. 15 plus 12 is how much? 27. So we need to get 3 divided by 9. We get 3. So 15, 12 and 3. So let's check whether it is working for next one. 44 plus 28 is how much? 44 plus 20 is 64 plus 8 is 72. 72 by 9 is 8. Yes, it is working. It's working. So it should be 64 plus 53. How much is that? 60 plus 50 is 110. 110 plus 7 is 117 divided by 9. 9, 1 times, 2 remains 9, 3 times. So it should be 13. Option B. Yeah, simple one. Add them, divide by 9. Add them, divide by 9, you got 13. Yes, let's mark it and go for next one. Question number 37, find the missing number. So first box says, so let's try multiplying it. 5 plus 3 is 8 plus 2 is 10 plus 4 is 14. So plus is not working. Let's try multiplying. 5 into 3 into 2 into 4. How much is that? 5 into 3 is 15. 15 into 2 is 30. 30 into 4 is 120. But we got 12. Yes, divide by 10. 12. Let's check whether it is working in the next cases. 5 into 6 into 2 into 3. 5 into 6 is 30. 30 into 2 is 60 into 3 is 180 divided by 10. Yes, it is working. It is working. Okay, next one should be 5 into 2 into 2 into 9. That should be divided by 10. You will get the answer. Okay, so 5 into 2, 10 into 2, 20, 20 into 9, 180. 180 by 8, 10 is 18. The answer should be 18. That is option B. The question mark should be replaced by 18. Everything multiplied, then divided by 10. Clear? Yes, mark it and go for next one. Next one, question number 38. Question number 38 says 4, 16, 25, 9, 14, 9, 14. If you see carefully, all these numbers 4, 16, 25, 9, 9, 49, 36, and 1 all are perfect squares. Now, from the first one, we have 4, we have 16, 25, and 9, the first figure. Okay, from this, this is nothing but 2 square, 3 square, 5 square, and sorry. Two square, four square, five square, and three square. Let's add everything. 2 plus 4 plus 5. 2 plus 4 is 6 plus 5 is 11 plus 3 is 14. That's how they've got the middle term 14. So similarly here, 9, 49, 1, 36. So this is 3 square, 7 square, 1 square, and 6 square. Add everything. How much will you get? 3 plus 7 is 10. 11 plus 6 is 17. Okay, the answer is 17. The missing term is 17. That is option C. You have taken the square roots of it and then added. Okay, yes. Next one, question number 39. Question number 39 is 4, 66, 3, 41. So let's subtract it first. So 5, so 2 and 1, but they have got 250. How did they get 250? They have just multiplied by 2, so they have, it is 250. So similarly here, 3, 98, 2, 82, subtract it. So 6, 1 and 1, 116 into 2 is 232, 232, that is option B. Subtract it, multiply by 2. That's the pattern followed. Clear? Simple ones. Very simple ones. Yes. We'll go for next one. Yes. Next one. Question number 40. Question number 40. 6, 4, 10, 8, 104. Okay. So let's multiply first. 10 into 6 is 60. 6 into 4 is 240. Not possible. Adding also doesn't work. Let's see with the consecutive numbers. Okay. So 6 into 4 is 24. Then this 2, 10 into 8 is 80. So if you add totally, how much will come? 24 plus 80 is how much? 104. Yes. So this 80 we got it from here, this 24 we got it from here, right? So similarly here, let's see whether it works. 7 plus 8, 7 into 8, how much is that? 56. 9 into 11 is how much? 99. So if you add it, it is 155. So it is correct. So answer should be, the answer should be 8 into 9 plus 5 into 14. Correct, no? 8 into 9 plus 5 into 14. Yes, 8 into 9 is 72. 5 into 14 is 70. The answer should be 142. Is that option there? Let's check. Option D, 142. Upper terms multiplied, added with lower terms multiplication. Simple one. Mark it and go for next one. Question number 41. Question number 41 says 5, 16, 49. 9, 29, 89, 15, question mark, 147, okay. So, from 5, you need to get 16. How can you get 5 into 3 plus 1, 16? Possible. So, from 16, you should get 49. 16 into 3 plus 1 is 49. Okay, that's working. Next. So, 9 into 3 plus 1 is not 29. So, what is it? Plus 2. Plus 2 is 29. Correct, no? Similarly, 29 into 3 is 87. Plus 2 is 89. So you saw first plus 1 is added. Next is plus 2 is added. So third one should be plus 3 addition. So 15 into 3 plus 3. So 15 into 3 is 45. 45 plus 3 is 48. If you want, check 48 into 3. Is 144, plus 3 is 147. The answer here is, what's the right answer? It is 48. That is option A. Mark option A and go for next one. Next one, question number 42. Okay, simple one. See, by looking at it, I got the answer. How? 4 into 3, 12. 12 into 3, sorry, 12 into 2, 24. So first box, 4 into 3 into 2 is 24. Next box, minus 2 into 2 into minus 1 is how much? Minus and minus becomes plus, 2 into 2 is 4. So anything multiplied by 0 is 0. 6, 0 into 6 into 5 is 0. So answer is 0. That is their option D. 0 is the answer, multiplication of everything, okay? This right hand corner is the answer for multiplication of all these things. Yes, we'll move on to next one. Next one, question number 43. Okay, 14, 12, 7 and 3. First, let's check addition. 14 plus 12 is 26. 26 plus 3 is 29. 29 plus 7 is 36. Just the addition, it seems. 12 plus 14 plus 7 plus 3 is 36. Okay. In the actual question, it is 9 plus 11 plus question mark, okay, plus 16 equal to 54. Got it now? We need to find the question mark now. So 9 plus 11 is 20. 20 plus 16 is 36. So question mark is equal to 54 minus 36, right? So what is question mark equal to? 54 minus 36 is how much? 54 minus 30 is 24. 24 minus 6 is 18. Correct? Is that option there? Yes, it is there. Option D. Simple one. Just addition. Okay, option D. Mark it and go for next one. Okay? So we have 64, 36, 49. What are these? Very, very simple one. 64. So first triangle, you have 64. 64 is what? 8 square. 36 is what? 6 square. 49 is what? 7 square. Add everything, how much will you get? 8 plus 7 plus 6 is nothing but 21. That's what they've done. In the next figure, I mean the diagram, 121 is 11 square, 81 is 9 square, 100 is 10 square. 11 plus 9, 20 plus 10, answer is 30. Okay, they have just taken the square and added it. You have taken the square root of all these values and then added to get the middle term. Answer is 30 here. Clear? Getting it? Yes. Mark that and go for next one. Next one, question number 45. Question number 45 says, find the missing number from the given responses. Okay. So first, let's add everything in the first box. 6 plus 0 plus 4 plus 5 plus 1 plus 3. How much is that? 6 plus 4 is 10, 16, 19. But how did they get 133? From 19, we need to get 133. So 19 into what is 133? 19 into 5, 6, 7 is 133. So let's check whether this is working for others also. 8 plus 2 plus 5 plus 6 plus 4 plus 3. 10, 15, 25 and 28. 28 into 7 is 7 is a 56, 5 gets carried, 7, 2 is a 14, 19, 196. Is it 196? Yes, it is. So answer should be 2 plus 1 plus 5 plus 4 plus 3 plus 7. Everything, the addition is multiplied by 7. That's a pattern here. Okay. So 2 plus 1, 3, 3 plus 5, 8, 12 and 22. So what is 22 into 7? So what is 22 into 7? So 7 to the 14, 1 gets carried, 7 to the 14, 154. Answer is 154, that is option C. Addition of everything and then multiplied by 7. Clear? 154 is the answer. Next one, 2 to 3. 2, 3, 5, 30. Okay. See here. Again, by seeing it only, I got the answer. How it is? 2 into 2 is how much? 4. 4 into 3 is 12. That is this 12. Similarly here, 2 into 3 is 6. 6 into 5 is 30. Correct, no? So, 5 into 1 is 5. 5 into minus 1 is minus 5. So, answer should be 4 into 3 into minus 1. 4 into 3 is 12. 12 into minus 1 is minus 12 should be the answer. That is option A. Just the multiplication continuously. First, second, third is multiplied. You got the answer in the fourth one. As simple as that. Clear? Yes, we'll go for next one. Question number 47. 47, 1, 8, 27. What are these? All are perfect squares. Yes or no? Perfect cubes. Perfect cubes. 1 cube is 1, 2 cube is 8, 3 cube is 27. So that's how it is done. Similarly, here 64 is 4 cube, 125 is 5 cube, and 6 cube is 216. Next, 343. 343 is 7 cube. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 7, it should be 8 cube, and here 9 cube is given. Okay. What we need to find out is this part, 8 cube, correct? So which is in black. What is 8 cube? 8 cube is equal to 5, 1, sorry. So 5, 1, 2. 8 cube is 5, 1, 2. Yes, so mark option C, 5, 1, 2 and go for next. All are perfect cubes here, perfect cubes, right? Next one, question number 48. So 8, 10, 14. Okay, this is like a series. So what is that series? 8 to 10, how much is added? Plus 2 is added. 10 to 14, how much is added? Plus 4 is added. So next should be 14 plus how much? Plus 6. So what is 14 plus 6? It is 20. Correct? 20 is the answer. It's like a small, simple series. So mark answer and go for next one. Next one, question number 49. Question number 49 says 1, 4, 2, 49. Okay. So 1 plus 4 plus 2 is how much? 7. How do you get 49? 7 square. Next one, 4 plus 2 plus 2 is 8. 8 square is 64. Okay. So question mark plus 5 plus 3 is equal to how much? That is 169. What is 169? 13 square. So we need to get 13 here. We already have 8. So what should be added? 5 should be added. So 5 plus 5 plus 3 is 13. 13 square is 169. So what should be the question mark here? It should be 5. Understood? They have added everything, then taken the square of it. Simple? Very simple. So answer is 5. That is option C. Mark option C and go for next one.
Question number 50. Question number 50 says 3, 4, 4 is 48. Let's check with multiplication. So 3 into 4 into 4 is 3 into 4 is 12 into 4 is 48. Working. 5 into 4, 4 into 5 into 3 is 60. Yes. So they are asking 5 into 3 into question mark is 105. So question mark is equal to 105 divided by 15. So what is question mark equal to? 15, 7 is 105. The answer is 7. Answer is 7, option C. Simple one, just multiplication. Yes? Yes, let's go on for next one. One, question number 51. Question number 51. 25, 49, 81. What is 25? 5 square. What is 49? 7 square. What is 81? 9 square. So 5 is there. Excuse me. Sorry. So 5 is there. 5 square. 7 is there. 7 square. So this question mark should be 9. Why I'm telling it is 9? See. So 5 plus 15 is 20. 7 plus 13 is 20. So 9 plus 11 is 20. So the answer is 9. Pakka 9. That is option A. Option A. Yes, mark the answer and go for next one. Next one. 341, 16, 5, 21. Let's see. So 3 from 341 and from 521, we need to get bracketed 116. So let's see. So 3 plus 4 plus 1 is how much? 8. So 5 plus 2 plus 1 is how much? 8. So 8 plus 8 is 16. That's why this is in bracket. So here answer option should be 4 plus 5 plus 2 plus 3 plus 2 plus 6. How much is this? 4 plus 5 plus 2 is 11 plus 3 plus 2 is 5 plus 11 should be 22. The answer should be 22. That is option B. That's option B. Clear? Mark it and go for next one.
Next one, question number 53. It says find the missing number from the given responses. Okay, and they have given 9, 6, 8. So first we'll take the first row here. So that is 9, 5, 7, 11. Now how can we get whatever value it is? 9 plus 5 is 14. 14 plus 7 is 21, but we need to get 11. We'll subtract 9 minus 5. Yes. 4, 4 plus 7 is 11, correct? So 9 minus 5 plus 7 is 11. We need to check whether it is working for next one also. So next one will be 6 minus 8 plus 4. How much is it? 6 minus 8 is minus 2 plus 4 is 2. So it is working. Last one will be 8 minus 4 plus question mark should be equal to 7, right? So 8 minus 4 is 4. So 4 plus question mark should be 7. So question mark will be equal to 3. Yes or no? 3. Because 4 goes that side, it becomes 7 minus 4, that is 3. So answer should be 3. That is option C. Clear? So mark option C and go for next one. Let's solve question number 54. 54th one is 147 is giving us 27. Okay. So you have 7, we have 4. When you multiply 7 into 4, it happens to be 28 minus 1 is 27. Similarly, 8 into 5 minus 2, because these two terms are multiplied, correct? So minus 2 becomes 38. Last one, so 9 into 6 minus 3. What is 9 into 6? 54 minus 3 is 51. So which is that option? Option C. Mark the option and go for next one. Question number 55. Question number 55 says 16, 25, 9, 36. Okay. First box. 16, 36. What is 16? It is 4 square. What is or square root of 16 is 4, square root of 36 is 6. When you add both, you get 10. Similarly, square root of 25 is 5, square root of 64 is 8. When you add both, you get 13. So the answer option will be square root of 9, that is 3, square root of 81, that is 9. The answer is 12. Simple one, very, very simple ones. Option A is the answer. Clear? Yes. Move on to next one. Next one, question number 56. These are little important kind of question, and the shortcut method for this is, what do they actually do here is, okay, these kind of questions are little repetitive. Here they take only 15, here they take only 6. Added both, you get 11 and multiplied by to get whatever number is given. So 33 we need to multiply by 3. See, for the next one if you want. So the second one, 22 plus 99 is equal to 33, correct? So they have taken 2 plus 9, that is 11 multiplied by 3, we got 33. Similarly, the answer will be 44 plus 88. What we'll do, we'll take 4 plus 8, it is 12 multiplied by 3. 12 into 3 is 36. Okay, 36, that is option A. Mark option A and go for next one. Next one, question number 57. What is question number 57 saying? 57 says 43 21 is equal to 35. 25, 40, 34, question mark, 35, 28. So we need to find out this value. So let's take the sum of everything, because 43 minus 21 is how much? 22, that is not 35. Let's add everything. So 43 plus 21 plus 35. How much is that? 43 plus 21 is 64. 64 plus 35 is 99. Okay. Let's see the next one. 25 plus 40 plus 34. Okay, 25 plus 40 is 65. 65 plus 34 is 99. That means we need to get sum as 99. We have question mark here. Plus 35 plus 28 equal to 90. It should be 99. Correct. So what is this? Question mark. So question mark is equal to 99 minus. Okay, what is the total here? 35 plus 28. 35 plus 20 is 55. Plus 8 is 63. Correct, 63. So question mark should be equal to 36. Clear? 36, right? So answer is 36. That is option A. Mark option A and go for next one. Next one, question number 58. Question number 58 says 7, 4, 2 is 69. Okay, from 7, 4 and 2, how did they get 69? 7 into 4 is 28, into 2 is not possible. Addition is not possible. Let's check the square. 7 square plus 4 square plus 2 square. 7 square is 49. 4 square is 16 plus 4. 49 plus 16 is 65 plus 4 is 69. Yes. So what they have done is they have taken the square. So answer is 2 square plus 6 square plus 5 square. How much is that? 4 plus 36 plus 25. 4 plus 36 is 40. 40 plus 25 is 65. The answer is 65, option B. Clear? Yes. We'll move on to next one. Next one, question number 59. We solved one kind of this. What was that question? Adding all this thing with this, we get the answer, right? We'll check whether same thing is working. 1 plus 7 plus 3 added with 5 plus 2 plus 6. This should give us the bracket value. Let's check. This is 11 plus, this is how much? 13. 11 plus 13 is 24. Yes, it is. The same kind of question. Repetition, same kind of question. Okay. So next one, answer should be 2 plus 5 plus 3. Okay. Plus 4 plus 7 plus 1 is equal to what? 2 plus 5 plus 3 is how much? 10. Plus 4 plus 7 plus 1 is 12. Answer should be 22. Simple. Answer option A, 22. Clear? Mark your answer and go for next one. Next one and the last one in miscellaneous and finding the missing numbers. So how many triangles? So first of all, we'll mark which are the triangles that are which easily visible. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 10 triangles are easily visible. Next one. 10 triangles we understood. Next one. Next one will be this, right? This is one triangle, the shaded one. Correct, one. This will be next one, that is two. Correct. So plus two. Right. Next, what is remaining? The bigger ones. Correct, the bigger ones, that is the whole thing like this. This is one. Okay, similarly two. Correct, it covered whole diagram. And this side, three and four. Right, so plus four we need to do. Plus four, what's the total? 10 plus two plus four is 16. Okay, is that option there? Is there an option called as 16 or more? Sorry, we have an option called as 16 or more. So obviously it should be 16. 16, it is 16 and or more. It can be more also, but we got 16. That should be enough. Clear? So that's it from Genesis side, from Deepak. So we have learned miscellaneous, finding the missing numbers in this video. You have mock tests, you have previous year's papers, so practice this. If you have any doubt, you can go through this video again. Thank you so much. We'll see you again. Thank you.